Afrobeat News, people, guys, it's me, Kelvin. Welcome back to Afrobeat News, your number one source of Afrobeat entertainment and just coming at you. Don't forget, guys, to like and subscribe as well as turn on post notification and stay tuned for more Afrobeat related entertainment and just coming at you. And let's jump right on into the news for today. First off, let's start with Davido. Now, Davido Obio has come out to reveal that at some point in his life, about 12 years ago, he was completely broke. He was dead broke and he didn't have any money, nothing to his name, but just pretty much a dream. And his cousins with him, B-Red and Shinorambo, he said he's ever going back to his former apartment back in Alabama. You guys should know that Davido used to school in Alabama in a school known as Oakwood College. So during that period of Davido's life, it turned out that Davido really had no money in his bank account. And most people would not really believe this, but I think this is true, because at some point in Davido's life, Davido was just doing his thing. He didn't spend so much time in school, even though he was in the US, didn't really spend so much time in school. Instead, he decided to chase after music, to pursue music. And during that period of time, I think he had clashes with his father, so he wasn't really getting as much support from back home. So he had to fend for himself, and it was just him, himself, Shinorambo, and his other cousin. I can't really remember his name right now. So yeah, that's pretty much what Davido came out to say. So without much ado, let me just read the headlines so that you guys can see the details of what I'm talking about. So Nigerian singer Davido has recounted the period in his life when he had no money and support. The music star and billionaire heir made this known via his Instagram page on Tuesday, February 23rd, 2021. This is what he wrote via his Twitter page. "Damn, I went to my old apartment where I used to live 12 years ago with Shino and B-Red. As hard as it is to believe, we had no money, no support, just us and a dream. 12 years later, with millions in, gold to billion, we thank God, never stop believing," he wrote. Now, first of all, let me just talk about one thing. First, people feel like Davido is not a billionaire because he wrote a road to a billion, right? And what he's actually specifying is $1 billion. So nobody should think that Davido is not a billionaire. In terms of Naira, Davido is worth more than 30 billion Naira. It's actually up there in the billionaire club when it comes to do it like Naira, but probably in the dollar club, he's not yet a billionaire. So I think that's what Davido is aiming at. So this guy is fully loaded. Anyway, moving on, and let's just continue reading the news. We have the music star is the son, of course, of the billionaire businessman and philanthropist Adedeji Adeleke. Davido schooled briefly at Oakwood College in Alabama, which he only stayed for about a year. After returning to Nigeria, he attended Badcock University, where he graduated with a degree in music. He rose to prominence in 2011 after he dropped the hit single Damijuro. Aside from his prosperous music career, the most followed Nigerian on Instagram lives with what many describe as an affluent lifestyle. He has investments in real estate, motorsports, and a very successful music label. So the music star, in a recent interview, revealed that he has plans to venture into politics. He has about 3 children from 3 different women. So this is pretty much Davido just coming out to spill the tea about his life. Davido right now is one of the biggest, richest celebrity out of Africa. If not the number one, I think he should be like at least the top 5 richest celebrity out of Africa. And I mean out of Africa, you have Davido leading. And even among his US counterparts, I'm talking about like top rappers out there, Davido can actually match them in terms of wealth. This guy literally has a lot of money in his bank account. And sometimes when he feature these foreign artists, I don't see it as a big deal, because I know that Davido can afford to pay them. You know, the last time he featured a foreign artist, which I think it was Lil Baby, right? He actually paid the guy over $100,000. Lil Baby Fett was a big money, but I'm guessing with Davido it wasn't too much to afford to spend. So Davido is currently like living a lavish lifestyle. This guy is crazy rich. And what I'm going to point out is just that it's quite surprising to think of the fact that this guy at some point in his life was broke. So he's saying 12 years ago he was broke, he was dead broke, he had nothing to his name, he was literally just, you know, struggling to survive with his cousins B-Red and Shinorambo. And 12 years later, this guy is currently one of the most famous guys in the planet, one of the most richest guys in the planet, living a very lavish lifestyle. I mean, go and check his home. This guy's house is worth millions and millions of Naira. He literally lives in a place that looks like a castle. Davido Bolling going big time, man, showing us how to live the lavish lifestyle and at the same time still stay modest enough to be able to tell us his origin, you know, the point in his life where he literally had nothing, no fans, and him just being with himself and with his dream and being very focused on his dreams and goals, man. So sometimes when people try to discredit Davido because of the fact that his father is so wealthy, I see it as just a complete nonsense, you know, argument. First of all, Davido is one of the most hardworking musicians out there. Davido literally work his ass off. Everywhere he goes, this guy is really putting in work. He's collaborating with artists almost every other day. This guy is currently one of the most hardworking, and rightfully so, one of the biggest artists out of Africa. So guys, that's pretty much what Davido had to say. Moving on to the next news of the day, we have the one and only Simi. Now, Simi, for me personally, she's like gold because she has a rare kind of voice. Her songs and music are very, very special. And I never used to be a big fan of her, but over time I grew to like her and like the kind of music that she produced, which is, I think, is so it's unique. It's just special, right? Just like, you know, her husband also, you know, Adekunle Gold. They produce kind of like a one of a kind of music. You can't have another Adekunle Gold, right? You have just one. You have just one Adekunle Gold. You have just one Simi. Their music is just distinct and special. Anyway, I'm not talking about their music today. I'm talking about Simi's Simi's tweet, because she made a tweet about her newborn baby. In case you guys don't know, Simi of recent gave birth to a bouncing baby girl, and it seems like being in that state, you know, of being pregnant, and after moving from that stage, going into becoming a mother, especially a new mother, it really makes you very sensitive and very emotional. And I think that's what Simi is going through right now. She feels the need to come out here to let people know how really deeply she feels for her child, because she's come out here to, you know, tell us that she feels solely responsible for her child, right? This is what she tweeted, right? She said, "Having a daughter has made me so vulnerable. I want her to never be hurt, sad, insecure, in pain, confused, or afraid. The fact I won't always be able to control these things have made me the most vulnerable I've ever been in my life." She also went on to tweet this, "I have to be the best example for her. So help me God." Man, this is one of the most heartwarming message I've ever read so far today. So it seems like Simi is in that her mother would face, that a very, very caring, loving mother would face, that I think with her it's just nice, because she has millions and millions of fans out there that are looking up to her. At least some people would get to learn how to, you know, treat their kids better, because unfortunately I have to say it, not everybody I have this kind of, you know, the heart for their children and all this kind of stuff like that. But it's pretty much Simi, right? I won't really spend too much time on talking about Simi's emotional state and how she's doing and what she's saying. I'll just read the headline about exactly what she said. So this is the headline, right? She said this, "Having a daughter has made me so vulnerable. Simi speaks about motherhood." Now, the Nigerian singer Simi has revealed how having a daughter has made her vulnerable. The music star made this known via her Twitter page on Sunday, February 22nd, 2021. This is what she tweeted, "Having a daughter has made me so vulnerable. I want her to never be hurt, sad, insecure, in pain, confused, or afraid. The fact I won't always be able to control these things have made me the most vulnerable I've ever been in my life. I have to be the best example for her, so help me God." Now, the mother of one recently celebrated her second wedding anniversary with hubby Adekunle Gold. The couple welcomed their first child in 2020. So guys, the more you think about, you know, Simi's tweets, you think it is emotional and it's loving and it's kind. Because that's what I think. Pretty much read that tweet, I just felt very, very heartwarmed. I don't know if you guys feel the same way. Tell me what you think about that particular tweet from her. And that's pretty much what I have for you guys today. Guys, don't forget to like and subscribe, as well as turn on post notifications. And stay tuned for more Afrobeat related entertainment. And just coming at you, I'm out for now, guys. Peace.